Hello, welcome. In this short video, let us look at the theorem on Kramer-Rao bound and an example illustrating this theorem. So the Kramer-Rao bound theorem can be stated as follows. For a random variable x, it has a probability distribution p of x with parameter theta. The probability distribution satisfies the following regularity condition defined as expectation of the derivative of the probability distribution. Expectation of the derivative of the logarithm of the probability distribution function, that is the PDF, is equal to 0 for all theta. That is, if this regularity condition is satisfied, then the variance of any unbiased estimator of theta, that is, for any estimator theta hat, which is unbiased, that is expectation of theta hat should be equal to the true value of theta, then the variance of theta hat, that is variance of the estimator, is lower bounded by the inverse of minus expectation of dou square by dou theta square of the logarithm of probability of x given theta. That is, the variance is lower bounded by the inverse of negative expectation of second derivative of the logarithm of likelihood function. And here the expectation is taken with respect to the probability distribution p of x with parameter theta. And moreover, the unbiased estimator theta hat can be determined if the first derivative, that is dou by dou theta, of the logarithm of the likelihood function has the following structure defined as I of theta multiplied by g of x minus theta. That is, if the first derivative can be written as a product of two functions I of theta and g of x minus theta, then the unbiased estimator theta hat can be determined. And this estimator will be the minimum variance unbiased estimator of theta. Now, we want to look at an example illustrating this theorem. Consider a case where we have an observation x of 0 is equal to a plus w of 0, where w of 0 has white Gaussian structure. That is, it has a normal distribution, it follows a normal distribution with mean equal to 0 and variance sigma square. Then the observation x of 0 also follows a normal distribution with mean equal to a and variance sigma square. Therefore, the likelihood function p of x of 0 with the parameter a is defined as 1 by square root of 2 pi sigma square exponential of minus x of 0 minus a whole square divided by 2 sigma square. So this is the likelihood function of the parameter a with the observation x of 0. Then the first derivative of the log of likelihood with respect to a is given by derivative with respect to a of the log of likelihood function is equal to the derivative of the log of this function, that is logarithm of 1 by square root of 2 pi sigma square exponential of minus x of 0 minus a whole square divided by 2 sigma square. So this is equal to minus logarithm of square root of 2 pi sigma square, and of course there is a derivative with respect to a, and minus x of 0 minus a whole square divided by 2 sigma square. Clearly, the first derivative with respect to a of the logarithm of the likelihood function is equal to 1 by sigma square multiplied by x of 0 minus a. Since the derivative of the log of square root of 2 pi sigma square with respect to a is 0, we only have this term. So, let us verify if this derivative satisfies the regularity condition required for the Kramer-Rao bound theorem. So, we want to first find the expectation of the first derivative of the log likelihood function. So clearly, expectation of the first derivative of the log likelihood function is equal to expectation of 1 by sigma square into x of 0 minus a. Clearly, this is equal to 1 by sigma square into expectation of x of 0 minus a. And since expectation of 0 is a, this is equal to 0. Therefore, the regularity condition is satisfied. Now, we know that the estimator of the parameter a hat is equal to x of 0. This is the maximum likelihood estimator. You can easily determine that the variance of the estimator A hat is equal to the variance of the observation, which is equal to sigma square. Next, the expectation of the second derivative with respect to A of the log likelihood function is, so the expectation of the second derivative is expectation of the derivative of the first derivative, which is 1 by sigma square into x of 0 minus a. And if you take another derivative, it is basically minus 1 by sigma square. So expectation of 1 minus 1 by sigma square, which is equal to minus 1 by sigma square. So according to Kramer-Raab bound, it is clear that variance of a hat is definitely equal to minus 1 by expectation of the second derivative with respect to a of the log likelihood function. Now we want to verify whether a hat is the minimum variance unbiased estimator that satisfies the condition in the Kramer-Raab bound theorem. That is, we compare it with the, by comparing with the structure given by the first, the expectation of the first derivative of the log likelihood function is equal to I of theta into g of x minus theta. By comparing this structure with respect to the first derivative, we can clearly see that I of theta should be 1 by sigma square and g of x should be x of 0. Now we want to verify what is the value of I of theta. In our case, it is I of a. Therefore, expectation of the first derivative with respect to a logarithm of the likelihood function x of 0, the parameter a, is equal to I of a multiplied by g of x minus a. Now if you go back to the CRB theorem, it clearly says that once the variance of the estimator satisfies the CRB, that is when variance of the estimator actually becomes equal to the Kramer-Raab bound, then we can easily determine the estimator if the first derivative has the following structure. That is, we can clearly see that the first derivative does indeed have the structure I of a into g of x minus theta. So that is, it has the first derivative, that is derivative with respect to a of the log likelihood function, is equal to I of a multiplied by g of x, which is x of 0 minus a. Now taking the derivative with respect to a on both sides, we have the second derivative, logarithm of p of x, that is the logarithm of the likelihood function, is equal to this first, the derivative of this function with respect to a, which is I of a multiplied by x of 0 minus a. And this is clearly equal to, the first derivative is the derivative of the I of a multiplied by x of 0 minus a. And the second derivative is minus I of a, since the derivative with respect to x of 0 is 0. So, by taking expectation on both sides, we can clearly see that the left hand side becomes expectation of the second derivative of log likelihood function. On the right hand side, the first term basically becomes expectation, the first derivative of I of a multiplied by the expectation of x of 0 minus a, and the second term becomes expectation of I of a, which is again I of a. Clearly, the first term is 0, the first term on the right hand side is 0, since x of z, the expectation of x of a is a and a minus a is 0. So, therefore, the function I of a is equal to minus expectation of the second derivative of the log likelihood function. And clearly, the variance of the estimator a hat is equal to 1 by I of a, where I of a, which is also equal to the negative expectation of the second derivative of log likelihood function, is equal to 1 by sigma square. And of course, the function g of x corresponds to x of 0. Thus, in the case of single observation, x of 0 with the model equal to x of 0 equal to a plus w of 0, we can clearly see that the maximum likelihood estimator a hat which is equal to the value of the observation itself is a minimum variance unbiased estimator, and as it definitely satisfies the Kramer-Rabaud theorem. And the variance of this estimator is also equal to the 1 by the function I of a, where I of a is equal to negative expectation of the second derivative of log likelihood function. Thanks for watching.